Hello learners, today in this class we are going to discuss about education of the children with special needs, whom we call as CWSN. A group that forms a very important part of equity issues at the elementary level is the children with special needs. You may have encountered in your classroom children with mild disabilities like locomotor disability, visual impairment, hearing impairment, lower level of intellectual functioning, and deficits in adaptive behavior. As a teacher, you have to deal with these children to improve their learning and performances along with other children in the classroom. Let us see a picture and try to understand and identify the features of CWSN. Learners, in this picture, I have brought for you some pictures related to the different disabilities of the children. For example, in this picture, I'm trying to show you the children with locomotor impairment. The main features of children with locomotor impairment is deformity in their legs, neck, waist, and fingers. In the other picture, learners, just take a look at this picture. Here, I have pasted one picture of children with partial blindness. The main features of children with partial blindness is deformity in their eyes, watery eyes, holds object close to the eyes. These are the basic features of children with partial blindness, identifying of which is very important for you while you are dealing with them in the classroom. The third picture that I have pasted here is of children with learning disabilities. The main feature of children with learning disabilities are lack in self-confidence, seeks repetition and practices. The first step in dealing with the CWSN is to identify them properly along with the degree of disability. The teacher has to probe the problem of such children through proper medical checkup, testing, and through observation of their behavioral characteristics. Once these children are identified, they are referred to appropriate persons or agencies to undergo a cure for their disability. Suppose, for example, children with hearing problem. They may require medical treatment and may require correction like hearing aid in order to overcome the disability. A child with visual problem may require lens or a magnifying glass. A child with locomotor disability may require crutches or a wheelchair to move around or some mechanism for adjustment of hands for writing. The curative and corrective measures are accompanied by adjustment in curriculum and classroom transaction with the objective of making the curriculum accessible to such children as to the other children. The provision that can be made in the classroom or school is to promote learning of such children, which are mentioned here. Suppose for the children with locomotor impairment, it is essential for you to accept such children in your class, ensuring that no critical comment on their disabilities is given by anybody in the class. He or she should be involved in all learning activities as an equal partner with his or her peers. It may be ensured that they have adequate opportunities to participate in the games, physical activities, and recreational activities at their level of functioning. In the classroom, suitable adjustment in view of the disability may be made in seating arrangement. The arrangement need to be such as not to create any physical hindrance to the child. In the assessment of performance of these children, particularly for grading or marking their disability, needs to be given due consideration. For example, if they have difficulty in writing, they may be provided with extra time. If necessary, oral testing may be used here. In some areas, they can record their answers on audio cassettes too. Now, children with visual impairment. These children are identified very easily. These are also partially sighted children. The vision of some of these children can be corrected through lens, but some can read only large printouts. Some may require magnifying glasses to read. Some children may have restricted field of vision. It is necessary to identify such children and refer them to the hospital for an eye checkup, inform the parents, and provide special help as mentioned below towards their education. Let us look at what we can do for them. You need to adjust such children in front rows so that they can read from the blackboard with ease. You need to write in bold letters which are legible. Repeat. You need to write in bold letters which are legible and read aloud what you are writing on the blackboard. Opportunities need to be provided to them for participation in physical education programs. A book stand may be arranged for the partially sighted children. In order to reduce the reading load of the child with visual problems, such children may be given training in listening with comprehension. They may be provided in the time schedule for a radio broadcast and encouraged to listen. Wherever facilities are available, audio cassettes may be used. Now, learners, let us know about the children with hearing and speech impairment. Some children have hearing difficulties and some have difficulty in speaking. Children with hearing problems may also develop speech problems. It is therefore desirable to identify such children and take necessary steps to meet their educational needs. Children with hearing problems should be seated in the front rows so that they can listen what you speak with ease. You need to use a reasonable level of pitch while speaking. Avoid mumbling and speaking too very fast. While you are demonstrating model or reading from the textbook, ensure that your lip movements are visible to such children so that they may be able to supplement listening by lip reading. Similarly, when speaking while writing on the blackboard, you should face the students rather than speak with face towards the blackboard. For the same reason, you may avoid moving while speaking. Peers may be encouraged to interact with these children and help one another in listening. Additional visual, individually or in groups, may be used to supplement general teaching input. If speech order is due to an organic defect in the speech mechanism, medical help is required. Speech defects arising out of hearing problems can be corrected through speech training using reinforced drill and practice. Now let us know about children with learning disability. Identification of specific learning disabilities require extensive training, and educational provisions can be made appropriate to the type and level of learning difficulty. However, some common and practical steps you can take to help such children in your class are: you have to provide more concrete experiences for these children. These experiences can be provided by available standard or improvised materials. Direct experiences from the local environment may be provided through field trips. These children require repetition and practice more than other normal children. While they are engaged in learning, simple questions may be asked to give them a feeling of success. The learning task has to be presented in small steps, and their attention needs to be drawn to improve points of the learning task because they have comparatively very small attention span. Immediate reward in terms of verbal or material reinforcements should be the watchword for these children. These children need to be provided with training on communication skills through practice in social situation. Curriculum for these children have to be transacted through simple and interesting learning experiences. One of the major thrust areas, repeat, one of the major thrust of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is to provide inclusive education to all children with special needs in general schools. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan ensures that every child with special needs, irrespective of the kind, category and degree of disability, is provided quality inclusive education in the general schools along with the normal children. It also supports a wide range of approaches, options and strategies for education of children with special needs. This includes special training in the form of school readiness program for CWSN, education through special schools, homeschooling and community-based rehabilitation. The ultimate aim would be to mainstream all CWSN in neighborhood school. So, dear learners, I hope by now you have learned at least a little bit of the CWSN, their characteristics, their features, and the educational provisions accordingly that we have to make for them. That's all for today. See you in the other class. Thank you very much.